On 16 January, we celebrate the feast of Saint Joseph Vaz, the patron saint of Goa. So I'm going to take you around this holy place and share with you some interesting fact on the life of Saint Joseph Vaz. Saint Joseph Vaz was born on 21st April 1651. Saint Joseph Vaz was a Goan born in Banauli at his mother's home, his father being from Sankwal. Saint Joseph Vaz was a third child of his parents, Christopher Vaz and Maria de Miranda, both of steady faith and deep religious sentiments. He was baptized on the 8th day in the parish church of Saint John the Baptist, Banauli. Born in a home where virtue was held in high esteem, where Christians' ethical and moral values were much emphasized, where fixed time was set aside for family prayers and spiritual reading, Saint Joseph Vaz grew up gentle and kind, greatly given to piety and endowed with singular love for the poor. Moved by the love of God, the young Saint Joseph Vaz chose to serve him as a priest. At a very young age, he cultivated the true wisdom which consisted in holy fear and love of God. His greatest aspiration was to make the Lord God known and loved by all men. He prayed for the conversion of souls and wanted everyone to belong to the fold of the church. These are the ruins of the pristine church of Sankwal. Saint Joseph Vaz signed his deed of bondage to Blessed Virgin Mary on the main altar of this church. In the year 1677, Saint Joseph Vaz wrote his deed of bondage, offering himself perpetually as a slave to the Blessed Virgin Mary to do what her divine Son Jesus willed with him. Let me read a translation of the text of the deed found in the book by Sebastian de Rego's Life of Venerable Father Joseph Vaz, which was published in the year 1962. The deed goes like this: Let all the angels, men and creatures who read this deed of bondage know that I, Father Joseph Vaz, sell and dedicate myself as a perpetual slave of the Most Holy Virgin, Mother of God. I do this by a free, spontaneous and perfect donation. This is an extract of the deed signed by Saint Joseph Vaz on the main altar of this church in the year 1677. After the letter of bondage, he remains in Goa for many years, and in the year 1686, without informing anyone except with the blessings of his perfect, he sets out from Goa on foot to go to Ceylon, now Sri Lanka. As you look around through this video, let me share with you the miracle of rain that happened in Sri Lanka. In the year 1696, there was a long continued drought in Kandy. As rain is necessary for cultivation of rice, the men, the crops and the cattle suffered. The king, through his courtiers, asked Saint Joseph Vaz to pray to his God and obtain rain for the kingdom. Saint Joseph Vaz, who by his sufferings, mortification and resignation to God's will had gained the power of sure intercession before God, and replied that he would pray with greater fervor in obedience with the royal command. Saint Joseph Vaz asked the king to remain firm in faith, and if it would serve divine glory, the land would abound with water, since all the elements obey God's divine commands as a creator of heaven and earth. Such an answer given with firm faith in God was followed by a prayer on the public square by Saint Joseph Vaz the next day. it brought abundant rains that Saint Joseph Vaz won the sympathy of the king, liberty for himself and permission to get more priests from Goa, besides a good number of converts to the faith. Saint Joseph Vaz is my favorite saint amongst all the saints in the world. I was a young bride married at the age 23 with the dreams to have many children, but it did not happen. I was told by the doctors that it is impossible for me to be a mother and it would be a miracle that would require for me to be a mother. Then, with frequent prayers and with the grace of Saint Joseph Vaz, I was blessed with a child who is 15 years today. I thank Saint Joseph Vaz for this gift to me and to the family. I ask Saint Joseph Vaz to intercede for us and to bless each one of us with good health. With that, I wish all of you happy feast.